I was honestly taken aback when I got that call. I'm still trying to understand, the ramifications of winning something like this. And I think what's really important is the fact that this particular story, gets to awards become a way to actually get the story further out. So for me, that's most important because I shot this in 2019 with the Caravan magazine, and it was important at that time, and through last year, the pandemic, and then now, I don't know what's going to happen with the laws and not, but I think it's important for people to know that it still persists. These stories still linger, especially in Assam and different parts of the country where they want to adopt these laws. I think wider the audience is better, because this people need to know about this. Look, I have a affinity, very close association with Assam, because I've been going in and out of a story since 2015 in Assam. I'm covering the erosion of an island called Majuli in Assam. So for me, Assam is close to me. But in that same year, in 2019, I thought I would go and document another chapter of my story in Assam, in Majuli. But there was something that was brewing in terms of in Assam that was, I think, larger than that point of time and that point of history in our country, which was the NRC. I was just cued into the fact that you hear these bits of news in different parts of the country about this concept, which is the Indian register, which is you have to be part of a register, you have to be part of you have to prove your citizenship. For me, that became something that I wanted, that really piqued my interest, because I do also have a Muslim name. So you go in as much without any bias, but I think objective news somehow does become subjective. You can't help it. And and just close association with Caravan. Then I just felt, I pitched the story to Caravan, and they were on board, and I went on my own to Assam and did my thing. One lead to the other, one district to the other, one horrific story to the other. It just, the more I heard, the more I wanted to dig deeper, and it became really evident what was happening. And that was my beginning with a chapter of the NRC. Challenges are, of course, as I said earlier, objective and subjective. How much can you feel versus actually know on the ground? So challenges were more personal, but again, I mean, you might do all your research before going, but the ground realities of really going deeper into the villages, going deep into people's homes, and you feel you're parachuting yourself again into these really, really traumatic kind of stories, where young people have taken their own lives because of fear of being excluded from the list. So nothing can prepare you for such stories that you're going to be hearing. Challenges are emotional more than anything else. And yes, I mean, it was challenges are emotional and weren't anything else. To be brutally honest, I don't know if my story or has particularly changed or been a catalyst for change in any way, unfortunately. But I do know that because of the readership of the Caravan magazine, that it has left an indelible mark on the reader, which has created awareness in parts of the country that would probably sit back and think that it's not going to affect them, but it actually does come around affecting all of us. So I think that for me is more important than, I don't know. I mean, yes, of course, legislative change. I don't think I can do it alone. And only organizations, news organizations and their support and viewership, readership, all coming together leads to protest, leads to questions being put out so that they can be answered. I think we've only been asking questions. I don't think answers are coming. And that is where we lag. So, I think the pandemic has slowed down the process a bit, but I don't think it's stopping a mentality in terms of the law.